Before the Santa Claus that so many of us know now, that jolly man stuffed into a red velvet suit, there was St. Nicholas. And this was his home. This was his church. But is it where he's buried? And why does it matter?
The spirit of Christmas comes with a dose of the macabre here. This is southern Turkey. It's 20 degrees in December, not a snowflake in sight. The famous St. Nicholas Church is almost entirely swallowed up by the greenhouses of this agricultural town. Nicholas was a priest in the 4th century, canonized for his generosity. The frescoes are faded, but they still give a good idea of what St. Nicholas was known for, helping children and sailors. It's that history that draws visitors from around the world.
It's quite remarkable to take the sort of the very commercialized image and take it back to like a real saint that actually lived, I don't know, 1600 years ago. And
centuries after his death in the Middle Ages, this church was as important a stop for pilgrims as Jerusalem. Even today, coming here is still a deeply spiritual experience. Dmitry Pozygin is visiting from Ukraine. It's his 4th time here.
For all Christians, and for us as Orthodox Christians, one of the most sacred place in the world.
But the place where they're praying, what's underneath, could make it even more significant. The Turkish team that's researching the history of this church, and it's been doing so for decades, says they found a structure underneath that place of prayer. And what's underneath could finally prove where St. Nicholas is buried.
It is important, the head of the Turkish team says, for religious history. Many believe St. Nicholas was buried in one of the caskets already on display. Italians insist the saint's remains were stolen long ago, whisked out of Turkey, and taken to Bari. Beyond the religious significance, there are also tourism dollars at stake. In Demre, where the saint preached and prayed, the faithful, like Anatoly Redder, says it's what Nicholas did, not where he's buried, that matters.
It doesn't matter where the remains are.
So. But the legend of the saint's stolen remains still pains them, the idea of a soul ill at ease. So they'll be going to Bari next, their way of uniting their patron saint's body and soul. Nid Köksal, CBC News, Demre, Turkey.